नमस्कार, हूँ आदर्श छू। वेलकम टू आदर्श एजुकेशन सोसाइटी। वेलकम स्टूडेंट्स टू फोर्थ पार्ट ऑफ 11th चैप्टर ट्रांसपोर्टेशन इन एनिमल्स एंड प्लांट्स ऑफ स्टैंडर्ड 7th साइंस। इन द लास्ट पार्ट वी डिस्कस्ड अबाउट द ब्लड वेसल्स, isn't it? And we come to know there are two type of blood vessels in our body, arteries and veins. Then after we were discussing about the arteries, in which we discussed that arteries carry oxygen-rich blood from the heart to all parts of body. Remember well, arteries carry oxygen-rich blood from heart to all the parts of body. Remember well. Then we discussed that since the blood flow is rapid and at a high pressure, that is why the arteries have thick elastic walls. That what we discussed in the last part. Now in this part, last time already we told that we will perform an activity. So what is the activity? Activity 11.1, available on the page number 122, open textbook page number 122, and keep a sharpened pencil also with you. Okay. चलो 11.1, द एम ऑफ दिस एक्टिविटी इज टू फाइंड पल्स रेट इन ए रेस्टिंग पर्सन। व्हाट इज द एम? टू फाइंड आउट द पल्स रेट ऑफ अ रेस्टिंग पर्सन। ओके, लेट्स गो फॉर दैट। रीड इन योर टेक्स्ट बुक, कम टू योर टेक्स्ट बुक पेज नंबर 122। Place the middle and index finger of your right hand on the inner side of your left wrist. First of all, this is my right hand, this is my left hand. But what to do? Place a middle finger and index finger. This is index finger through which we can index somebody. That is why this is index finger and this is middle finger. Why? Because out of five, it is in the middle. So place your index finger and middle finger, and where to place? On the inner side of your left wrist. On the inner side. Now let me show you one thing. See, if you will push here, now you will find two strong muscles are there. Can you see that? Do it with yourself. And okay, two strong muscles are there, and after that strong muscles, then after push your these fingers and place there and push it. You will find, if you could not find, then do it repeatedly. Change the place. After some time, you will find somewhere. See, here I can feel. Okay. So where to push? See, you can see here there is a muscles. And then after, place your two fingers over here and push. Thoda sa. Push there. You will find something. What is there? Let's go for that. So, place the middle finger and index finger of your right hand on the inner side of your left wrist like this. Okay. Then, can you feel some throbbing movements? Now, what is throbbing? See, throbbing, an instance of rapid strong pulsation of heart, this is rapid strong pulsation of heart. You will find something is moving there rapidly and strongly. And you will feel that. And that is a heart pulsation. Those are heartbeats or heart pulses is there. Okay. Why do you think there is a throbbing? Why do you think there is throbbing? कुछ मतलब हो रहा है ना rapidly. This throbbing is called pulse. This throbbing is called pulse. And it is due to the blood flowing in the arteries. This throbbing is called pulse. And why? This is due to the blood flowing in the arteries. We know that previously we discussed that since the blood flow is rapid and at a high pressure, the arteries have thick elastic walls. Okay, that's what we discussed previously. But as there is a pressure rapid, there is a pressure, high pressure in the arteries, and that is why and that heart is beating. That is why you will find that the pulses are there. Okay, and this throbbing is called the pulse, and it is due to the blood flowing in the arteries. Count the number of pulses beat in 1 minute. Now what to do? Count the number of pulse beats in 1 minute. So what you will do? You will keep your watch over here, okay, and start counting the pulses within 1 minute. How many pulses are there? So once you start your watch and start the counting the pulses, suppose see what I am feeling. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. That is what my feeling is there. You also will feel something like that and count the pulses within 1 minute. There are how many pulses? Okay. Now, how many pulse beat could you count? So within 1 minute, how many pulse beats could you count? Now underline the things. The number of beats per minute is called the pulse rate. Underline that. The number of beats per minute is called the pulse rate. So what is pulse rate? The number of beats within a minute is a pulse rate. Underline that. Then after, once again underline, a resting person usually has a pulse rate between 72 and 80. A resting person usually have a pulse rate between 72 to 80 per minute. Find other place in your body where you can feel the pulse. Find other place in your body where you can feel the pulse. Then record your own pulse beats per minute and those of your classmates. Record your own pulse beats per minute and those of your classmates, and insert the values you obtain in the table. Compare them. So you can see there is a table on the page number 123, table 11.1, pulse rate, isn't it? In which there are three columns are there. Serial number, thereafter name, and then after pulse per minute. Pulse per minute. Okay. Now, first of all, record your heart rate or pulse rate. Okay, suppose serial number 1, we are not going to name, but we will name it like that is CD. Suppose name is A. Now record your pulse rate, see whether it is 72, 73 or 80. Suppose your pulse rate is 74. Now pulse per minute, remember that, 74. Now see, if your friend is not there, then you may go for, you may go to find out the pulse rate of your sister, your brother, your mother, your father, like that, isn't it? Find out and note down there. Say serial number 2, name is B. Suppose the pulse rate is 72. Sometimes it may be serial number 3, C, and the pulse rate may be 78. It may be there. Okay, so like that, you find out the pulse rate of your family members or your persons, and you will come to know. You will come to know while a healthy person is resting, then the pulse rate used to be between 72 and 80. Okay, so this is what we discussed in this chapter. Now, in the next part, we will discuss about the veins. We will discuss about the veins. But by this time, let me tell you, I am ending this part. Do this activity at your home, and if you could not understand, then watch this video once again. But before closing, I would like to remind you one more thing. Why? Because in the next part, otherwise you will get confused. That is why remember one thing, is that arteries carry oxygen rich blood from the heart to all the parts of the body. Arteries carry oxygen rich blood from the heart to all the parts of the body. Remember that. Why? Because while we will understand the veins now, otherwise you will get confused. Okay. By this time, let's end this part. Thank you for joining us. Take care of yourselves, and we'll meet you in the next session. Thank you.